Jason Saggo, 26 years old. I have a record of 6 wins and 1 loss.
I'm Eric Attard. I'm 25. I live in Welland, Ontario. I do most of my training in Niagara. I also in Buffalo and Toronto.
Eric Attard, I know he's a well-rounded fighter. He's explosive. He has good low leg kicks. I've seen a little bit of footage on him, and he just seems like he comes to fight, so it's going to be a good one. And I'm coming. I'm training really hard. I'm ready for anything. Good to go. Awesome instructor out of North York, so Atlanta Muay Thai and MMA. I trained my jiu-jitsu and MMA under Paul Abel, and then also for my wrestling, I've been recently going to Guelph University.
It's going to be a tough fight. Jason Saggo is a tough competitor, and I expect to see a great war.
Ready?
Hardline, hardline as a hardline. That molten power holds all my people. They took turns. Just beat the suit tie at night.
Adrian starts with his back against the cage. You get to go in, pin him there. You gotta hold him there for the 45 seconds that you got him. Okay, if you can get a takedown, get a takedown. Yeah, Adrian, spin him around, take him down back. Every time you get them down, get right back up, put your back against the cage, they put you there again, okay?
Either finishing by knockout or submission.
And I'm looking for the knockout.
I should say, I hope you train your ass off, man, because I'm in the gym twice a day, every day, and let's put on a good show for the fans.
Train hard, and I'll see you on the 25th.
Get ready for August 25th. It's going to be a war. I'm ready for war.
I'm ready for a war!
So I'm Eric's MMA coach. I met him 5 years ago. He signed up at my original school. After a typical Eric, you know, long time thinking about it, I had a lot of questions, making sure that we're legit. Yeah, I've been his coach ever since. He started fighting amateur 3 years ago, turned pro 2 years ago.
Jason's brown belt underneath me in Gracie Jiu-Jitsu. I met him about 7 years ago at a Jiu-Jitsu tournament, and he started training with me about 5 years ago. We train primarily Jiu-Jitsu. I fought Thai boxing quite a few years ago, so we do a little Thai as well, but I'm not his strict coach, but I am his MMA coach as well. He's a very dedicated student, works very hard, and he's great at what he does.
What makes Eric unique from other fighters is he's unpredictable. You're not sure where he's coming from. He's very good at cutting angles. Whether the fight is standing on the ground against the cage, it doesn't matter. He has all the tools. He works diligently on every area of the fight, whether it's his striking, his ground, his wrestling, his jiu-jitsu. He makes sure that this is his job, and he takes it very seriously. And that's basically it. Committed as far as fitness, diet, everything. What you're seeing is a professional athlete.
Attitude, dedication, open-mindedness, asks a lot of questions, but never for any reason other than to learn, never to put down, never to question for the sake of questioning, only because he seriously wants the answer, and he listens.
Have we been doing anything different with this training camp? Not really. We're pretty straightforward. We're doing a lot more sparring, but other than that, no, our conditioning is basically the same. Our techniques, you know, we always evolve. Since we're always in competition, we're always in fights, we have a large amateur team, we have a growing pro team. So whether new things are happening, we're always staying on top of it. We don't stay stale every time. You know, are we doing that much different? In my mind, no, because I'm here every day. But if I took a look at the way we were doing things a year ago, 2 years ago, yeah, we're definitely doing a lot different. So, yes.
Trying to make all the connections. We're trying to explore the idea of making sure that all the arts are connected to one another, rather than just doing wrestling, just doing jiu-jitsu, just doing Muay Thai, but finding the links and the flows. We've been working on that pretty hard. And also understanding when it's time to get back up again. I really like when Jason has guys on the ground, but there's a time to get back up. Just understanding when that time is.
I see Eric unleashing an unbelievable hurricane. His hands are solid. His ground is solid. Saggo's going to have nowhere to hide. There's nowhere to hide in this way. I can see him winning TKO. Submission, maybe, maybe not. I know Saggo's an excellent grappler, but in order for Saggo to do what he was going to want to do, he's going to have to fight through an unbelievable hurricane.
I see submission in the second round. That's the way I see it. Second round submission.